Hello everyone, this is Prof. Lee from Copperbelt University in Zambia. Nice to meet you everyone. Today, I would like to talk about the person who is needed in this society and how you can prepare for it. So, about the job interview. Do you know who this person is? Who is he? Yes, some of you know, but I think most of you do not know who is he. Yes, he is Sir Shackleton. He attempted to explore the Antarctic, but failed. He has failed. Yes, he was the greatest loser. You know, it's very interesting, is it? Yeah, he has failed, but we called him the greatest loser. He's a failure, but he's praised as the greatest reader after God. It's true. What made him the greatest reader in the world? That is the point, what I want to share with you. That is also the thing related to job interview. On his way to Antarctic, his ship was trapped in ice and sank. Yes, it's true. After sailing southward for months and battling increasingly hostile conditions, thumping ice floes, yes, for over 6 weeks. The name of the ship was Endurance. Yes, that Endurance eventually became totally entrapped by a pack of ice on the 18th January 1915. As you see, yes, that the Endurance was sinking. Shackleton and his crew were trapped for 10 months before having to evacuate a sinking ship. 10 months. The story of Shackleton's miraculous escape and the survival of all his crew is legendary. Yes, it's legendary. How they could survive from the serious condition without any losing anyone his crew. Almost 600 days, almost two years, without enough food, under the serious condition. So that's why we call this story, the story of the Shackleton, is, yes, legendary. It's true. We would like to remind you that the man sailed 1,300 kilometers in nothing more than glorified rowboat. Yes, around them, there is only rowboat, not the luxury ship. As I told you, already the ship was sinking. So that's why around them only row boat. That's it. How they could survive under the serious the circumstance. Also, the battered, treacherous seas with little navigation equipment. So that's why they should climb the mountain range and few glaciers. It's true. And then go back with the help to rescue 22 of his men stuck on Elephant Island. Yes, he left to get the help from outside, leaving his crew on that Elephant Island. And he came back. He came back to his crew with the help from the outside. It's true. Yes, the point what I want to share with you is how he selected, how he had selected his crew. That is the point. Because in the beginning, I told you the point, what kind of the talent nowadays our society is looking for. So, in the beginning, Shackleton received over 5,000 applicants for his Antarctic expedition. When recruiting for his Antarctic expedition, Shackleton received over 5,000 applicants. Among them, he chose only 26 among over 5,000. He chose only 26. Can you imagine what was the selection standard by him? That is the point what I want to share with you. That is the point. You should know exactly selection standard, how the global company select new employee. With what the standard? That is the thing what I want to share with you. So among his many requirements, something like some of the practical ability. Yes, among his the requirement, he also quizzed potential sellers on range of slightly more bizarre skill. Unique skill, something like their ability to hold tune. Specifically, yes, something like the ability to sing a song. It's very unique. It's very interesting, isn't it? Yes. He was looking for his crew. So instead of looking for some of the practical ability, some of the experience related to sailing, instead of that, he was looking for unique talent, something like singer-song. That is the point. That is the point. What the skeleton wanted was not a fantastic resume, covered lots of experience, but the point is attitude of heart inside of you. That is the point. Not the fantastic resume covered lots of experience. That is my point. Here, I would like to introduce you very unique global Japanese company, which has a very unique selection process. Yes, this is a Japanese company called, my name is the Nide Motor Company, working in production of industrial motors. It's a global company. It has established office in 33 countries, and its global annual sales is approximately 1 trillion yen. Huge company, global company. But that company has very unique selection criteria. That is the point what I want to share with you. It's very unique. This company hires new employee based on three things. How fast it get rise? What did I say? Yes. How fast it get rise? The second one is reading books loudly. How they can say something loudly? That is the second point. The last one, the third one is cleaning the restroom. It's very unique, isn't it? Yes. I want to tell you one by one. Once candidate has passed the document screening and initial interview, yes, they send the candidate to a cafeteria and give them cheap lunchbox. Given 10 minutes, each candidate are selected on their ranking of how fast they finish their eating. That is the first criteria, as I told you. It's very interesting. Everyone, how much time do you take to eat your eat? 10 minutes? 20 minutes? Or maybe an hour? If you took more than 10 minutes, you would not be an able employee of this company. Of course, all of you here today are not trying to get a job in this country. Yes, I know. But if you are a young person trying to work here, you'd probably have to train yourselves to eat much faster. Why? Nowadays is more important. The fact is speed, and you can eat your food fastly means you have strong stomach. So means you are healthy. So that's why they accept this the criteria as their selection criteria. That is the point. It's very interesting, but that is not my point. The second brilliant test is to have a candidate read the short paragraphs loudly. Of course, reading something loudly does not help one to understand the contents of the paragraphs. It's true. But it is the test of how precisely the person is able to accurately read the sentence in the paragraph. Yes, this the second criteria is a little bit related to some how you can communicate with others precisely, exactly. You can read some of the paragraphs. The precisely means, yes, You can have some ability to communicate with others. So that's why they select this, the criteria, also the second selection, the criteria. Yes. And this is very unique also, but that is not the point also. So the third one is the thing, what I want to share with you. Yes, this is the cleaning the restroom. Everyone, I don't like the cleaning the toilet. As you can imagine, because of the bad smell, awful smell. How about you? I hate them. I hate them. So, but anyway, this company orders all their candidates to clean the toilet. You can imagine the candidate who attended some interview meeting, something. Yes, they expected getting some the interview, but instead of the getting interview, suddenly, if they were asked to clean the toilet, what you should do? Can you imagine? Yes, that is the situation the new candidate were facing. It's true. Why would this company use such a strange method for the new employee selection? That is my point. I would mention about a little more about the third the criteria. Why would this company use this such the strange the criteria for their the selection criteria? As I told you, I hate the cleaning toilet due to bad smell. That is the point. I can imagine you also. But if we should do, we should have the mindset, attitude to sacrifice myself for others. That is the point. So that's why this company needed use these three criteria for their selection criteria. Shouldn't it cause the company fail? No, absolutely no. Absolutely opposite. The senior executives of this company, its current the senior executives of their company, all of them are employed in this manner. It's true. Yes, this criteria has contributed greatly to their company's growth on a global scale. It's true. How is it possible? Employees are not selected by their good school grade in school. No, absolutely no. Whether they graduated from good university? No. If they are good looking, not on special superficial standard, they are rather testing for their heart. As I told you, their heart inside. Cleaning toilet is something people hate to do. As I told you, therefore, it is a dumb thing they would hate to do as well. However, if it were absolutely necessary, you need an employee who would carefully do their best, who is willing to sacrifice themselves for the sake of everyone else. That is a point. You need an employee, those kind of people. No matter what hard or the difficult work you give him, that person must possess the healthy mindset. What is a healthy mindset? Means allow them to overcome those tasks and achieve their goals. Then you have a truly amazing employee. That is the point. These three standards are not the only standards used to select an employee candidate. But however, it is very, very important and unique and advanced technique to acquire inner knowledge of your new employee, inner knowledge of the person. So that's why needed, yes, selected those kind of the unique the selection criteria for selection of the new employee. So everyone, I want to tell you another very unique the story. Do you know who are they? Is there anyone whom you know? Yes. A person at the left, he is Mr. Sundar Pichai. Yes, he is now the current CEO of Google. Yes. He wants to get a person who can do collaboration. Yes, that the criteria is same as Samsung. You know, the company of the Samsung of Korea? Yes. The CEO of the Google, the Pichai Sundar, yes, he has the same criteria of the Samsung, the collaboration. The second one from the left is the, as you know, the founder of Microsoft. Yes, Bill Gates. Yes, he chooses the people who make the challenge, who can do the volunteer work for their society. Yes, it's the same the criteria of Hyundai, company of Korea also. The third person is the previous CEO, the Jack Welch. Yes, previous the CEO, Jack Welch. And the last one is CEO of the Costco, Jim Shaniger, who wants to select the people with affinity. Yes, the global company select the people with the same standard. How about your country? Zambia, Zimbabwe, Malawi, other southern country. How about your country? This is trend of global trend. This is a global trend. But how about you? In my opinion, you are focusing on the good school grade and some of the certification from some of the university or the dumping. No, forget it. Everyone, forget it. As you know, one of the global companies, Samsung of Korea, as you see, yes, they require challenge, creativity, cooperation, and communication skill. That is the global trend. Value created with the commitment, the creativity, and the collaboration. Challenge the future with the commitment and passion. Make the world better through creativity and the learning, connect, communication, and collaborate with open mind. That is the talent they are seeking for. It's global trend. Okay, from now on, shall we look at it one by one? Yes. The first question is commitment. Just before I told you, the talent the global company they're looking for is Yes, commitment, challenge, and the creativity, collaboration, the communication, those kind of things. So, I will show you some of that. The first one is, as I told you, commitment. The first question is commitment. All questions, as you see, all question is about the future. Yes, commitment is related to the future. So, you should know the reason why they are asking those questions. You should know exactly the purpose why they are asking to you about the commitment. Means, in other words, means your future. That is the point. That is the fun. Are you going to stick around if you are hired? Is something most employees want to know. In other words, after you get hired in that company, they want to know, your employer want to know, you should stick in that company, or in short time, you are leaving. Your commitment, commit to in your the work in their company or not. That is the point. So that's why they are asking to you your future. That is the point. That is the point. So as you see the question, as I showed you, for example, in my slide, that is all that the question is related to the future. That is the related to commitment. All these questions will gauge your interest in making commitment. If you know exactly the purpose of that question, maybe you can easily answer. So that's why you should know the purpose of the question. Why they are asking me those kind of the question? That is my point. Your dream and the future plan are all questions related to this. You should know exactly why you should have precise the dream for your future, or what kind of the plan for your future you should have. That is the same reason, that is the same purpose. So, you must consider what your clear dreams are. You should have. Yes, interview can be challenging even for the best communicator. So, responding effectively means achieving balance between listening and telling something. In other words, balance between listening to what the interviewer is asking. First one, you should try to hear very carefully what the interviewer is saying. And then you should tell something, you should answer something. And then providing a well thought out response to the question. That is, there is some balance between hearing, listening, and speaking. That is my point. In addition to the response you give, your ability to communicate will be evaluated. During the hearing and the speaking something, yes, during that, yes, the evaluator will gauge your ability to communicate with others. Yes, what are your verbal and the non-verbal communication skills like? How well do you explain your answer? How articulate are you? Do you listen carefully to what the interviewers are saying? Or do you interrupt and try to dominate the conversation? Yes, that is the point. The ability of listening, hearing, without trying to interrupt others and something. And then, how you can express your opinion well. That is the point. Do you look your interviewers in the eye when you speak to them? What does your body language say about you? Means you should have eye contact with your interviewer always. Yes, whenever the interviewer says something, you should have eye contact with them. Or also, when you speak to something to your interviewer, also, you should have eye contact with them. That is the point. That is, in other words, your body language. If you try to avoid someone's eye or something, as you can imagine, yes, they can evaluate, they can have some doubt of your the communication ability. It's true. So that is the reason. Body language means, yes, some how you can express your idea and something through your attitude, body language. Sometimes nodding your face, nodding your head and something, or something smiling, or something eye contact, those kind of things. That is the factor of the commitment also. Yes, here are the top communication skill the hiring manager will evaluate you. As you see here, the slide, listening, confidence, empathy, friendliness, non-verbal communication, as I told you, your body language, respect, how clear and concise your response are. It's true. So, while taking the conversation between you and the interviewer, always you should keep your eye on their face, on their eye, means eye contact. Sometimes you should express your body language just like nodding your head and something. Or sometimes give them smile, your smile. That is the body language. That is the communication skill. Including those kind of the body language, they can evaluate the ability of your communication skill. How you can hear, how you can express your opinion through the verbal language and something. That is the point. The second one is, yes, collaboration. Collaboration is a connection, communication with open mind. So, why are you the best person for this job? What if you can ask to answer to this question? Why are you the best person for this job? In this case, you should say, well, I don't know the other people you are interviewing. So I can say, I am the best. Why you should say those like something like that? Because, yes, polite, humble, that's it. And then you should express your ability. What you did, that is 2 points. Please don't boost your own. And then you but anyway, with the confident attitude, you should say also what you did in your past the work and something. That's it. That is the way how you can answer. The third one is motivational interview, those kind of things. Motivational question is very common part of the interview process. Exactly, you should know. So one typical question is, as you see here, what motivates you? Means, why do you want to this job? Little bit looks the ridiculous the question. In fact, yes, why we are looking for job? Because of money. Yes, we know. Everyone knows it. But if you say, because I want to have some money, you can imagine the result. So, yes, exactly, we know. We are interested in the money, but you shouldn't say just like that. You shouldn't say. Say, any question in this category that helps a hiring manager understand when you feel enthusiastic, what drives your success, and whether what motivates you is a good fit with the job responsibility. That is the point. The best answer to motivational question is, you should be honest and you should give them some of the result connected with the job you are applying for. That is the point. Your response should strongly suggest you would be highly motivated by and suited for and the work involved in the role at hand. It's true. So when you are preparing to answer this question, you should think about this. What have you enjoyed while working at previous position? You should give them some the exact, concise, precise result what you did. Think about your day-to-day work and your broader interest. That's the point. What types of tasks are you the best at? In what sort of environment? So something like busy, deadline-driven, cooperate, something like that. But you never mention about some of the paycheck, some of the wage, something. When they ask you, how much do you want to get some of the salary and something? In that case, you should say, but before that, you never mention about. Even though, what if you want to get the job because of the money, but you never say that. You understand what I'm saying? It's true. The best answer to motivational questions are, as I told you, honest. And your answer should be connected with the company culture. Yes, with that, you can say. This kind of the interview, we call that behavior job interview. In the behavior job interview, the company asks questions about your past work experience. Why? Because that your past work experience is related to the result of your future work. So, they wanted to find out if you have the skill needed for the job. That's it. So, this kind of the interview focus on how you handled, in the past, the various work situation. That is the point. If you did well in your the previous the work, yes, they expect you, yes, you would well the future in the future task. That is the point. So your response will reveal your skills, ability, and personality. The logic behind this interviews is your behavior in the past reflects and predicts your how you will behave in the future. That is the logic behind this interview. But remember, interviewer isn't necessarily asking yes or no. So it may help you review how to answer interview questions without right or wrong answer. Respond to these sort of the question with a specific example of how you have previously handled the similar situation in the workplace. Yes, answer to behavior interview question should be in the form of brief anecdote that illustrate your strength and skills as a worker. Previous background on what situation, the specific actions you took and result. We call that star technique. As you see in the picture, situation, what kind of the situation you under, what kind of the situation something you should explain, and what did you do, task, and what you should do, the specific action you took, and then what was the result. So situation, task, action, result, we call that STAR. So this STAR technique is excellent way to organize your thought. There are four steps. Situation means describe the situation in which the event took place. Task means you should explain precise task what you took. Action, explain what action you took to complete the task or the solve the problem. Result, explain the result of your actions. For example, if your action resulted in completing a task, resolving the conflict, improving your the company's sales record, something like that. Explain just like this, exactly. Try to focus on how your actions resulted in a success for your company. That is the point. So here, some example, behavior interview question. Tell me about how you work effectively under the pressure. Have you ever made a mistake? How did you handle? When you get some of the question from your interviewer, number two, have you ever made a mistake? Don't worry about it. As a human being, we can easily make mistakes. So, the point is whether you made a mistake or not. No, never. The point is how you can overcome those situations. That is the point. You should keep in your mind. Don't try to express yourself as a good man. Never, as I told you in the beginning, from the case of the Shackleton, as I told you, he was loser, but nowadays he is respected as a great leader. He was a failure, but how nowadays we respect him as a great leader? Because of his result? No, as I told you, He was a loser, but he is respected as great, one of the great leaders. That is the point. So, please don't try to express yourselves as a good man. No. Instead of that, you should try express, show them how you could overcome under the circumstance. That is the point. Give an example of the goal you reached and tell me how you achieve it. That is the point. You understand what I'm saying? Yes. Have you handled a difficult situation? How? That is the point. So, the best way to prepare your job interview is you should keep in your mind. Age of 900, yes, through that the case of the Shackleton, yes, attitude of hurt. Nowadays, 2000, age of 2000, yes, mindset. You should keep in your mind, mindset, not a spec. Healthy mind, that is the point. Thank you very much for listening. Thank you all.